Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. BestInSlot here, and tonight we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do a movie review slash recap of the film, The Jurassic Games, a dinosaur film that came out only this year to absolutely zero fanfare. There are going to be mild spoilers in this review, as much as you can spoil a film like this, so be warned ahead of time if you have for some reason been dying to see a low-budget Jurassic Park slash Hunger Games hybrid, and don't want to ruin it for yourself. With that said, let's get started. So, The Jurassic Games. The basic premise of the film is something that's been bandied around for a long time. What if we put death row inmates into a publicised challenge mode and let them battle for their freedom? In the film universe, these annual games have become kind of a big deal, the TV event of the year, and at several points in the film, as people are horrifically killed, you'll actually see citizens of the world shriek in the light of the bloodshed. People are monsters, basically, is the premise I'm getting from this. The games work by selecting 10 death row inmates and strapping them into these Oculus Rift-like devices. If you die in the game, you get a lethal injection in real life and also die. The contestants all get snazzy little profiles detailing and often showing, really in quite a lot of detail sometimes, their brutal crimes. And even the ones you sort of like turn out to have murdered 500 people or kicked a puppy or something. Anyway, they must battle across 4 different zones and rounds with different environments, challenges, and bloodthirsty dinosaurs and other prehistoric creatures. The first, for example, requires them to reach a safe zone whilst being chased by a Tyrannosaurus Rex. The second, a maze filled with Jurassic Parkified Velociraptors, I'm hoping that catches on as a word, and so on. The inmate that survives the longest earns their freedom, and since you're allowed to kill each other, that raised an inherent problem for me. Basically, the more violent and bloodthirsty you are, the better your chances of survival and being released back into a society where you definitely probably maybe wouldn't continue to murder absolutely everybody just like you did the first time. One of the contestants, for example, is a bug-eyed cannibalistic dude who takes every chance possible to chomp down on the necks of his fellow contestants, seemingly convinced it's the best method of attack rather than, you know, strangulation or a rock to the face. Just eat them afterwards, man. You don't have to eat them to death, you absolute bloody weirdo. Most of the contestants, if I'm honest, aren't that interesting. There's a nice looking old man who dies pretty much immediately, because he's older than everyone else and therefore useless. There's an Asian guy who seems pretty chill, but of course knows really elaborate martial arts, because damn the stereotypes. There's a couple of brothers who, now that I think about it, really resemble Daryl and Merle from Walking Dead. There's a woman who I thought was sort of cute at first, but turns out to be a goddamn monster, and a guy that is basically the Viper from Game of Thrones. None of them get much personality other than being angry or weird, and that includes the main hero. I think his name is Tucker. I've kind of forgotten. Anyway, in a shock twist, he's a bearded white man with short cropped hair who loves his family, and was, of course, wrongfully convicted of his crimes. This to me felt like a little bit of a cop-out. Of course it's easy to root for the one innocent amongst 9 other proper psychos, but it's more fun to make us root for an anti-hero who, okay, don't make him a serial murderer or a dog kicker or something, but maybe he could have accidentally killed someone while drunk driving or something. Make him flawed. Make him make a mistake. Don't make him innocent. There's a few other characters dotted around. There's a host who pops into the game every now and again wearing a bizarre Smilodon-esque mask, the woman who runs the game who is basically Cruella de Vil, and a few people associated with a protest group who are campaigning against the games, you know, for fairly obvious reasons. That all comes to a head eventually in a truly bizarre ending sequence, which I won't spoil because I want you all to waste 90 minutes of your lives watching this film. You'll notice that I haven't really talked about the dinosaur yet, and that's probably why you're all here. The reason they haven't come up is because they're not actually that big a part of the film, unfortunately. By far the most screen time they get is during the second challenge where the weird, thick, and I do mean with 2 C's, raptors are heavily featured. But other than that, there's a lot of human-on-human stuff, punctuated with a host of different prehistoric beasties which get a few seconds of screen time, including a Smilodon, some weird scarab things that I'm pretty sure are lifted directly from the mummy, a Triceratops, and of course, the Rex. The CGI is, surprisingly, actually pretty damn good. The film lacks flair and style in general, but the dinosaurs look alright for a low budget flick, particularly the ones in the final challenge where you get to see some proper dinosaur on dinosaur action. It's a surprisingly cool scene. It's definitely a step above those cheap films you see on sci-fi anyway. There's also a pretty cool idea in play, in that the dinosaurs are brought into the game via a console at the home base. These are controlled, their aggression, their spawning patterns, stuff like that, and I've rather seen a whole lot more of that over the "I am a bad angry person," that's my angry voice, dialogue and person-on-person combat we get for most of the film, since it is actually a pretty interesting idea. Overall then, the film is okay. It's shallow and schlocky with mediocre acting and barely a plot, sure, but it's got decent looking dinosaurs and it doesn't take itself too seriously. If you've got 90 minutes to kill and want to see some angry people killed by prehistoric creatures and each other, you could do a lot worse. To close out, just before we finish, I'm gonna let you guys into some of the, I sat down when I was watching the film with a big notepad and I wrote down a series of different notes. So this is a collection of notes that I scribbled down in the film. Giant spider, that was on screen for like 2 seconds. Sauropods, kinda cute. Compy eats ear, these were in capitals. Nice man introduced, very dramatic. Jesus Christ, so dramatic. I'm Albert and I'm going to eat you. The games produce action figures for children basically, including the cannibal, who is, according to my notes, called Albert. Spunky murder love interest? Question mark. And finally, where the hell are the cameras? Thanks for joining me, folks. Obviously, this isn't something I've really done before, and I'd like to expand on the format, spruce it up a little bit. I think we could maybe spoil a bit more about the film as well, though. Hey ho. But only if you guys at home are interested in more. If you are, let me know in the comment section down below, and by hitting the like button, it really does make a difference. It lets me know that you guys enjoy the content. If people are into it, next up we'll be taking a look at The Jurassic Dead, which, yes, is a film about dinosaurs and zombies, and dinosaurs that when they bite you turn you into a zombie. It sounds amazing. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end, this video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.